गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू मैथमेटिक क्लास ऑफ ग्रेड 6, चैप्टर 5, अंडरस्टैंडिंग एलिमेंट्री शेप्स, एंड दिस इज योर समरी लेक्चर. इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल रिवाइज वॉट एवर वी हैव लर्न इन दिस चैप्टर. फर्स्ट थिंग दैट वी हैव डन इन दिस चैप्टर इज कंपैरिजन ऑफ लाइन सेगमेंट. Comparison of line segment means finding a relation between their length. If we are making two line segment, one is this AB and the another is this CD. So comparing these two line segment according to their length, we can say that AB is smaller than CD. This is called the comparison. If the difference is big, then we can find out this comparison with our eyes only by mere observation. But if the difference is very minute, then it is difficult to find out which line segment is bigger and which one is smaller. So here are three methods to measure a line segment. One is by observation only. By observation, we cannot get the accurate result. Second is using tracing paper. Using tracing paper gives us the accurate result, but it is a lengthy procedure. And the third is using a divider. This method gives us the most appropriate results. So we will follow this method only. Next, we have done length of a line segment can be measured accurately by using ruler and a divider. This just I have told you that with the help of ruler and divider, we can get the accurate measurement. Next is when a hand of a clock moves from one position to another. We have an example of an angle. Okay, if one hand of a clock moves from one position, from one number to another, this is a form of an angle. See, this is your clock. Suppose our hand moves from 1 to 4. Okay, it is moving from 1 to 4. If the difference is of, if the gap is of three numbers, from 1 to 2, one number, from 2 to 3, two number, from 3 to 4, three number. If the gap is of three number, it means it has covered one right angle, that is 190 degree. And one right angle means 1/4 of a revolution. Okay, and if it moves from 1 to 7, here, from 1 to 7, now the gap is of 6 number, okay, and it is forming one straight line also, that means it is making an angle of 180 degree. And it means it covers, as it is a straight angle, it means it covers 2/4 part. You can cut it, 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, so it is 1/2. In the same way, if 3 more gap is there, then it is a 3/4 turn. Now see, when a hand of a clock moves from one position to another position, we have an example for an angle. Okay, so one full turn of a hand of a clock is one revolution. If the clock moves from one complete revolution, one full turn, starting from 12 and it ends also at 12, that means it took one complete round. It means it is completing the angle of 360 degree, because complete revolution is of 360 degree. A right angle is 1/4 turn and a straight angle is half turn. Just now I have told you, if one right angle is there, then it means 1/4 turn. And if it is an angle of straight angle, 180 degree, then it means it is 1/2. Now next is how we measure an angle. We use a protractor to measure the size of an angle, and the unit to measure an angle is degree. We measure angle in degree. This is the unit of the angle. And how we measure angle with the help of protractor? This is the protractor I have told you. Suppose this is the angle made. Now how you measure this angle? The center point of the protractor, this point you will keep on the vertex, and this baseline of the protractor will be on the baseline of your angle, like this. Okay, now your baseline is towards your right hand side, so you will see this side 0 degree. So start always from 0 degree. 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Line, this ray lies between 40 and 50. So it is a 45 degree. Okay, this is the way how we measure the angle. Now see the types of angle. Types of angle, first is acute angle. What is an acute angle? An angle whose measures lie between 0 degree and 90 degree is called acute angle. Or we can say acute angle measures between 0 degree and 90 degree. Next is right angle, that we have done earlier also. An angle whose measure is 90 degree is called right angle, and normally right angle is L in shape. Okay, and acute angle is less than right angle, so it is this gap between two rays is smaller than right angle. Next is obtuse angle. An angle whose measure is lie between 90 and 180 degree, that means more than right angle but less than straight angle, then it is an obtuse angle. Next is straight angle. An angle whose measure is exactly 180 degree, straight line. This is an example of straight angle. Straight line always measure 180 degree. Then reflex angle. An angle whose measure lie between 180 degree and 360 degree. Suppose this is the angle we have made. So this backside angle is an reflex angle because it is more than 180 but less than 360 degree. After that we have done perpendicular lines. What are perpendicular lines? Two lines that intersect at right angles. When two lines bisect, intersect at each other at right angle, then we can say that they are perpendicular to each other. See, these are the examples of right angle. Here these two lines are intersecting and the angle between them is 90 degree. This T also, here it is making the angle of 90 degree. Or we can say adjacent sides of a tabletop, that is also an example of perpendicular lines. After that we have done perpendicular bisector. The perpendicular bisector of a line segment is a perpendicular to the line segment that divides it into two equal parts. Means when the two lines intersect also at right angle, okay, and dividing a line segment into two equal parts. Just see this. Suppose I have made one line segment here, AB. This is line segment AB and this is a perpendicular bisector CD. This CD bisect AB at point E. This is a perpendicular bisector, so it is dividing AB, it is bisecting it at right angle. Okay, and if it is AE is equal to EB, if AE is equal to EB, then we can say that they are perpendicular bisector, because it is perpendicular also, making the angle of 90 degree, and bisecting AB also. AB is dividing into two equal parts. So this is a condition of perpendicular bisector, that it will make the angle of 90 degree and divide the given line segment into two equal parts. Now we will do types of triangle. Types of triangle we can classify on the basis of sides and on the basis of angles. First of all, see, on the basis of sides. If in a triangle all the three sides are equal, okay, if all the three sides are equal, three sides equal, then it is called a scalene triangle. It is a scalene triangle. If two sides are equal, if suppose these two sides are equal, this is a triangle ABC, and in this AB is equal to AC. Okay, so two sides are equal, then it is an isosceles triangle. And if all the three sides are of different length, if all the three sides are of different length, then it is a scalene triangle. Let us repeat once. If all the three sides are equal, sorry, here it is not scalene. If three sides are equal, then it is an equilateral triangle. If three sides are equal, equilateral triangle. If two sides equal, then isosceles triangle. If all the three sides are of different length, then it is an scalene triangle. This is the classification of triangle on the basis of sides. Now we will do on the basis of angles. Okay, acute angle, right angle and obtuse angle. See now. If all the three angles are acute, all the three angles are acute. Acute means less than 90 degree. In a triangle, if all the three angles are less than 90 degree, then it is called an acute angled triangle. It is called acute angled triangle. If all the three angles are less than 90 degree, or we can say if all the three angles are acute. Okay. Next is, if one angle is right angle, if one angle is right angle means 90 degree. So if one angle is of 90 degree, then it is a right angled triangle. Okay. And the third type is obtuse angled triangle in which one angle is obtuse. It looks like this. If one angle is obtuse means more than 90 degree but less than 180 degree. So if one angle is obtuse, that is more than 90 degree but less than 180 degree, then it is called a obtuse angled triangle. This is the third type of triangle on the basis of angles. Hope you remember this table. This table we have done earlier. A parallelogram has opposite sides parallel and equal. All the sides equal in parallelogram? No. Opposite angles are equal? Yes. Diagonals are equal? No. Diagonals are perpendicular? No. Means diagonals are not bisecting each other at 90 degree. Then rectangle, opposite sides are parallel? Yes. Opposite angles are also equal? All the sides are not equal? All the angles are equal, that is 90 degree. Diagonals are also equal and diagonals does not perpendicular to each other. Then square, in square opposite sides are parallel, they are equal also. All the sides are equal, opposite angles are equal, diagonals are equal and diagonals are perpendicular too. In rhombus, opposite sides are parallel, opposite sides are equal, all the sides are equal, opposite angles are equal, but diagonals are not equal. Okay? And they are perpendicular to each other. Next, trapezium. In trapezium, opposite sides are parallel. Yes, but only one pair of opposite sides is parallel. Opposite sides are not equal. All the sides are not equal. Opposite angles are also not equal. Diagonals are not equal. And diagonals are not bisecting each other at 90 degree. These are the properties of quadrilateral. Then after quadrilateral, we have done some 3D shapes. First one is cube. Okay, a cube has 6 faces. Let me write down here first faces, edges, vertices. A cube has 6 faces, 12 edges and 8 vertices. Same in the case of cuboid also. Cuboid also has 6 faces, 12 edges and 8 vertices. It has 2 circular edges. These 2 circular edges. Okay. So we can write down here 2 circular edges. And how many vertices it has? Vertices means corners. It does not have any corner. Okay. Now see the cone. In cone, it has 2 faces, one plane and one curved. One plane and one curved. And how many edges it has? It has one circular edge. One circular edge and one vertex. Okay. Now see the triangular prism. What is a triangular prism? Did you remember it? Triangular prism. Triangular prism is like this. It's both the side bases are triangle and it is like this. Looks like a kaleidoscope. Okay. It has 5 faces, 9 edges and 6 vertices. This is a triangular prism. And triangular pyramid? Triangular pyramid. First, me tell you the shape of triangular pyramid. It is from here, it is triangle base, just like a tent. This is a triangular pyramid. How many faces it has? It has 4 faces, 6 edges, and 4 vertices. This is a triangular pyramid. After that, we have done square pyramid. Square pyramid is square from base. It is square and join it like this. Okay, how many faces it has? 5. Okay, 4 from these sides and 1 is the base one. So it has 5 faces, 8 edges and 5 vertices, 5 corners. This all we have learned in this chapter. Now it's time for the homework solution. Your homework was to do exercise 5.8, question 1 and 2 in book and 3, 4, 5 in rough notebook. Question 1 and 2 of exercise 5.8, they are very simple. First is you have to tell, examine whether the following are the polygons. If any one among them is not, say why. First figure is like this. It is like this. Is this a polygon? No, it is not a polygon because the definition of polygon is that it is a simple closed curve and it is not closed, it is open. If the starting and ending points are two different, then it is an open curve. Second one, yes, second one is a polygon. Third, C is a circle. So it is also not a polygon because it is not made of line segment. And D is also not a polygon as it is made like this. Okay, so here it is a curve. So it is not a polygon. So only B is a polygon. B is an example of a polygon. Second question is, name each polygon. You have to name polygons. I have told you how to give name of a polygon by its sides. In first figure, 4 sides are there, so it is a quadrilateral. In B, it is 3-sided, so it is a triangle. C, it has 5 sides, so it is a pentagon. And in D, it is 8 sides, so it is an octagon. So polygon names we can give by its sides. Then I have given exercise 5.9, question 1 and 2 to do in book. Okay, that is very simple. That you have done, I know, very easily. And then I have given to do this of page number 110, in which you have to write down properties of cube, triangular pyramid, square pyramid, triangular prism. That I have told you just now. Okay. So now your homework, today's homework is do assignment uploaded on EdQuark site. I will upload one assignment on EdQuark site. You have to complete that assignment and prepare chapter 5 for test. This is your homework. To do the assignment, okay, that will be uploaded on EdQuark site, and prepare chapter 5 for test. But before that, you have to complete this chapter in your notebook. If there is any pending work, then do that first. Thank you.